Hello friends, this video on NEET ATOMS is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. Let us now talk about the energy levels of atoms. Now, as per Bohr theory, at a particular orbit, an electron has a particular value of energy. Right, because as we saw that as the value of n changes, for n is equal to 1, there is some amount of energy that the electron can have. For n is equal to 2, there is a specific amount of energy that the electron can have. Therefore, energy depends on the value of n, and the value of n defines the orbit in which the electron is revolving, right? So the energy of the nth orbit of the hydrogen-like atom, I mean, either it is hydrogen atom or hydrogen-like atom, is given by minus 13.6 Z square by N square electron volts. Now, here we will not discuss about the derivation, like how did we derive this, because for that we have already explained this chapter, all these topics in detail. So just refer class 12 physics video on atoms. So there you will get all the derivation from where do we get this, right? So, but this is how we calculate the energy of nth orbit, energy of an electron in nth orbit in hydrogen-like atom, right? So here we see that the energy depends on Z square and inversely depends on N square, correct? Now, what happens when the electron jumps from one energy level to another? As we have learned before, that when an electron jumps from a lower energy level to a higher energy level, like as you see in this picture, the electron jumps from n is equal to 1 to n is equal to 3. In that case, a photon is absorbed. That is, some external energy is provided, right? So now the question is, this photon which is getting absorbed, this photon would also have a frequency, it would also have a wavelength. So how do we relate that wavelength to this electron which is jumping from one energy level to another energy level? So for that we have this expression which says that 1 by lambda, where lambda is the wavelength of the absorbed photon. So that means this photon which is getting absorbed has a wavelength lambda, such that 1 by lambda is equal to Z square R 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square, where N1 represents this energy level, this is N1 and this is N2. So N1 represents the lower energy level and N2 represents the higher energy level. What is Z? Z is the atomic number. And what is R? R is nothing but the Rydberg constant, right? So R basically is a constant in this case, correct? So this is the relation which tells us what should be the wavelength of the photon that needs to be absorbed so that the electron can jump from a lower energy level N1 to a higher energy level N2. Now, in a similar way, we can also find out the wavelength of the emitted photon when the electron jumps from N2 to N1. Just the reverse thing, right? So there also, we can make use of a similar expression to find out the wavelength of the emitted photon. Now, this is about the wavelength of the absorbed photon. What about what if we want to find out the energy of the photon? So we know that energy of the photon is h nu or hc by lambda. So basically, if you multiply the left hand side and right hand side of this expression with hc, you will be able to find out the energy of the photon. So this side, it would be z square r hc into 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square. Right. So here hc by lambda is nothing but energy of the photon. So we can say energy of photon is equal to z square rhc into 1 by n1 square minus n2, 1 by n2 square. Now this rhc, if you see, these are all constants. R is a constant, h is Planck's constant, and c is the speed of light. So these three are constant. And if you put their values, it comes out to be 13.6 electron volt. And this RHC is often, this when taken together is often called as the Rydberg constant. So therefore we can say E is equal to 13.6 Z square into 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. So this is how we can calculate the energy of absorbed photon. Not only absorbed, but the same expressions will be true for emitted photon also, when the electron is jumping from a higher energy level to a lower energy level. So you just need to understand the concept, what is happening here, right? Okay. Now let us talk about few important terms which are very commonly used, but a lot of us are not very clear about these terms: excitation energy, ionization energy, and binding energy. So we will start with excitation energy. The term is very simple: excitation, something that is needed to excite an atom. So the energy that you need to excite an atom from a lower state to a higher state. As I said, that if you are in the ground floor and you need to climb the stairs to reach the fourth floor, so you actually need to put in a lot of energy. You need some extra energy. Maybe you will take a glass of glucose, you will drink 2-3 glasses of water, you will get some energy, and then you will start climbing the stairs, because to go from the ground state to the excited state, some energy is needed. So that energy which is needed to excite an atom from lower state to higher state is excitation energy. Now let us take the example of, say, hydrogen atom. Okay, so let's say for the hydrogen atom wants to go from n is equal to 1 to n is equal to 2. Right? So in order for this atom to get excited from n is equal to 1 to n is equal to 2, how much energy would be needed? So as I have told in the previous slide, that when an atom goes from lower energy state to higher energy state, you need to provide some energy. So how much energy will you provide? The energy of the photon, which is hc by lambda. So this energy E would be equal to 13.6 into 1 by n1 square. So here n1 is equal to 1 and n2 is equal to 2, because you want to go from n1 to n2. So this would be 1 by 1 minus 1 by n2 square. So 1 by 4. So this will be equal to 13.6 into 3 by 4, which is equal to 10.2 electron volt. So this 10.2 electron volt is the excitation energy for hydrogen atom to get excited from n is equal to 1 to n is equal to 3. So the value of excitation energies would be different for different energy levels. Let's say if the hydrogen atom wants to get excited from n is equal to 1 to n is equal to 4. So now when you want to go from ground floor to first floor, you need lesser energy. When you want to go from ground floor to 10th floor, you need a lot more energy. So the same thing is true here. So when the atom wants to get excited from n equal to 1 to n is equal to 2, then it needs 10.2 electron volt. When it wants to get excited from n is equal to 1 to n is equal to 3, so the value of energy would change. Right? So you will have to calculate, you can easily calculate the values of excitation energies for different energy levels. Right? Okay. Now let's talk about this next energy, that is ionization energy. So this is the energy which is needed to ionize an atom. Now the biggest question here is, what do we mean by ionizing an atom? So ionize means to make an electron jump from the present orbit to an infinite orbit. So why do we say that? Let's say hydrogen, this H, when we write H, this is hydrogen atom. Now when you want to ionize H, what do you mean? You mean that you want to make it H plus, right? That means you want to snatch away one electron from the hydrogen. So what are you basically doing? You are basically taking out one electron from the present orbit, wherever the electron is present, whether it is present in the n is equal to 1 level, 2 level, 3 level, or wherever, but you want to take that electron and snatch it away. That means throw it to the infinite orbit. So that is what you are doing in ionization, right? So we can say that an ionization energy is that energy which is needed by an electron to jump from the present orbit to infinite orbit. So how will you calculate ionization energy? So you can say that ionization energy is equal to energy at the infinite orbit minus energy at the present orbit. So this present orbit is some nth orbit. Now what would be the energy in the infinite orbit? So we know that energy is proportional to n, inversely proportional to n square. So for infinite orbit, n is equal to infinity. So 1 by infinity is 0, therefore energy in the infinite orbit is 0. So this minus energy at the nth orbit. What is the energy at nth orbit? It is 13 minus 13.6 into z square by n square. So basically the ionization energy for the hydrogen like atom would be 13.6 into z square by n square electron volt. So this is ionization energy. So see, these concepts are very important because many a times you are asked a numerical where these terms are used, like ionization energy, excitation energy, and many a times children do not understand what are these energies, and they just want to put that energy value in some formula that they know, which is not the right approach. So that is why I am spending time to explain you these three kinds of energies. So I hope the ionization energy part is clear. Now we will talk about binding energy. So what is binding energy? Binding energy is all about the energy that you need to separate the nucleons from each other. What are nucleons? The protons and the neutrons, which are present inside the nucleus, they are together called nucleons. So if you have to separate those nucleons, now why do these nucleons stay together? Because of the attractive nuclear force. So if you want to separate the nucleons, you need to overcome that nuclear force. So you need to provide some extra energy, and that energy is called binding energy. So another way of defining binding energy is you want to make an electron jump from the ground state to the infinite state, right? Because in this case, because when we talk about the binding energy, we are basically talking about an atom in its ground state. So right now the atom is in its ground state, and again we want to separate it and send them to infinite state. So how can we calculate binding energy? Binding energy is equal to the energy at the ground state, because energy at the infinite state is zero, right? So this would be minus energy at the ground state. So binding energy can also be written as E infinity minus E1, right? So E infinity is equal to zero. So it is minus E1, which is equal to minus, what is the energy at the ground state for hydrogen atom? It would be 13.6. So this will be equal to plus 13.6 electron volt. So this would be the binding energy of hydrogen atom. So please understand the difference between ionization energy and binding energy. In ionization energy, you need to send the electron from present orbit, and that present orbit could be any orbit. It could be ground state, it could be n is equal to 2, it could be n is equal to 3, to infinity. Whereas in binding energy, you want to send the electron from ground state to infinity. So these are the three types of energies. Thank you. Please visit examfear.com for free quality education. You can learn with a simple four-step learning process wherein you can watch video lessons, you can ask your questions, you can refer notes, and you can take a free online test. We have content for class 6 to 12 on physics, chemistry, mathematics, and biology, along with practical videos. So please subscribe to our channel for daily updates. Thank you.